Last week, naging available na sa GCash ang mga aggressive funds ng Atram. It just so happened na meron akong pera sa GCash. Nag-test buy ako doon para malaman natin ang pros and cons of using GInvest as a long-term investment marketplace. Let's begin! Sa mga hindi pa familiar sa GInvest, it is an investment marketplace sa loob ng GCash. It is available to GCash users na verified na at na KYC na. And then in this marketplace, they offer investment products. Right now, yung only investment product provider available is Atram, which is a UITF fund provider. Punta tayo sa pros and cons of investing in GInvest. Unahin natin ang mga nagustuhan ko with this marketplace. Ang pinakaunang nagustuhan ko dito is that it is very easy to join. All you need is an active GCash account. Verify mo lang yon, tapos tapusin mo lang yung KYC ni GCash, and then you're ready to go. Once na nakapunta ka sa GInvest na section, if first time mo gumamit ng GInvest, then magbibigay sila sa iyo ng questionnaire that you need to answer. Yung questionnaire na to will assess your appetite for risk when entering investment products. After that, kung may pera yung account mo, you can now buy your first investment product in GInvest. Speaking of funds, marami kang pagpipilian in this investment marketplace. Pwede kang pumili ng local, pwede rin na global. For example, if you want to enter the Philippine Stock Exchange, pwede na yung Smart Index Fund ng Atram yung piliin mo. Kung gusto mo naman ng International Consumer Stocks, pwede na yung Consumer Feeder Fund yung piliin mo. Another thing that I liked about GInvest is that maliit yung barrier to entry dito kasi 50 pesos lang yung minimum investment. Unlike sa other types of funds na 1,000 pesos minimum, may iba pa nga na 5,000 pesos minimum. With GInvest, kahit na maliit lang yung pera mo in GCash, pwede ka agad mag-start. In addition, there is no minimum holding period. Tapos, walang additional fees si GCash. Kasi if you are experienced with mutual funds, sometimes merong sales load associated with the transaction. In this case, walang transaction fees right now. It may change in the future, pero right now, wala pang transaction fees. So all in all, what GInvest offers is convenience. Convenient mag-invest ng pera dito kasi all you need to do is put your money in GCash and mag-buy transaction. Now, let's go to the downside of investing in GInvest. Before we proceed sa downsides ng investing in GInvest, may request lang ako sa inyo, paki-press na lang ng like button sa baba, and then if you like, pwede rin kayong mag-subscribe. It's free and it helps out the channel a lot. So, let's move on. Now, let's go to the downside or possible na mga downsides when it comes to investing in GInvest. One is the lack of transparency. The very first one wherein merong lack of transparency is yung management fees. Kasi hindi na mention ni GCash in their website na meron talagang management fee si Atram. You need to go to the Atram product na webpage para malaman mo yung management fee. And right now, yung mga management fee ni Atram ranges between 0.9% and 1%, which is already around the middle when it comes to investment products. So ganoon si Atram kumita. Every year, kumukuha sila ng 1% or 0.9% from the asset under management. Sa lahat ng pera na hinahawakan nila, they take 1% to 0.9%. Depende kung magkano yung management fee ng particular fund na nakuha nyo. Tapos, kukunin nila yung management fee na yon regardless if positive or negative yung performance ng fund na yon. That means, kumita man or nalugi yung fund, kukunin pa rin nila yung management fee na yon. Pero, what I'm telling you right now is that okay lang yun. Kasi lahat naman ng investment funds, merong management fee. And yung Atram is medyo mababa, yung management fee nila, compared to other traditional investment funds. So if nagsabi si GCash na walang fees yung pag-invest sa GInvest, what they meant siguro was that walang transaction fees. Pero when napasok na yung pera mo sa Atram or any other investment company na pasukan mo through GInvest, meron yang management fee taken every year. Another downside na pwedeng mag-impact sa performance ng investment mo sa GInvest is yung transaction delays. Meron silang table sa GCash website kung saan nakalista yung transaction delays. So for example, yung PSE index fund ni Atram, meron daw na 3-day transaction delay if dumaan ka sa GInvest. So if Monday ka bumili ng PSE index na fund ni Atram, what will happen is either Wednesday or Thursday pa papasok yung transaction mo. And we don't know what the buying price will be. And for me personally, this is a big issue because one of my favorite ways of buying in the stock market, kahit ano pa yung asset na yan, is to buy on the dips. That is the strategy kung saan you wait or binabantayan mo yung market. If bumaba yung presyo, bibili ka. Because that way, nalulower mo yung average mo when you are peso cost averaging. Because of the transaction delays in GInvest, hindi ka makaka-buy on the dips. And for me, that is a big disadvantage in the market. So overall for me ba, ano ba yung GInvest? Is it a good way to start? Is it a bad way to invest? Well, in conclusion, considering yung convenience nito, it is a very good way for beginners na mag-start sa market. Pero if you are like me na meron ng access sa iba't ibang brokerage accounts, sa mga UITFs, then this may not be for you. Kasi there are other ways to access Atram funds. If PSEI naman yung gusto mo, I prefer na matime ko yung market, matime ko yung entry ko because that is where you can actually beat the market. If you time your entry na bumili ka during the dips and you lower your average buying cost. A word of warning lang guys, if you decide to use GInvest or kahit na ano na investment fund, always learn the underlying assets kasi meron yung kaakibat na risks yung bawat type ng asset na iniinvestan nyo. So, malalearn nyo yan using the prospectus of that fund. And I will leave a link sa baba para ma-access nyo yung mga prospectus ni Atram. Tapos, always remember that past performance does not dictate future performance. So just because na nakita nyo yun na last year, nag 100% yung isang fund, it doesn't mean na this year or next year, the same rin yung mangyayari. Because particularly last year, it came from a low base. Meaning ng low base is bumaba yung price niya. If bumababa yung price ng securities, mas likely itong mag-bounce back at tumaas. Kaya mataas yung mga performances ng securities last year and mga funds na associated sa securities na to. And if you want to learn more about this type ng usapan, mag-subscribe lang sa channel because it exactly ito yung mga types ng content na pinag-uusapan natin dito. So kayo guys, what do you think about GInvest? Is it a good way? Meron ba akong na-miss na mga pros and cons? If meron, pakilagay na lang sa comments sa baba. And if you enjoyed the video, remind ko lang kayo, paki-like and subscribe. And ingat guys!